Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, in this video we'll discuss about the derivation of centripetal acceleration using calculus method. Hello students, let us start with the derivation of centripetal acceleration. Using calculus method. This is also I'll keep in 1.5 because in 1.5 we discussed about the centripetal acceleration. That was the first method, geometrical method. This is the second method, which is the calculus method. You might have some other method, but that is not required. But this one we will consider. Now, in calculus method, first of all, let us say that this is a circle. Okay, this is a circle and this is the radius at position 1 and this is at position 2. And this is supposing the reference line as well. This is your x-axis and I'll consider this as the y-axis. In x-axis direction, the unit vector is I cap, in y direction it is j cap. J cap or j hat is the unit vector along x and y respectively. Now, what we are interested in is to find the expression for acceleration. The acceleration is the rate of change of velocity. And how to find the change in velocity if it is the case of uniform circular motion. The particle is moving from any point O to any point B along this line. This is the center. Here the velocity here is V. Here also the velocity is V. How to find that? In terms of calculus method, the acceleration, we will break up things like acceleration is dv over dt. That means v is what? V is dr over dt. This is rate of change of displacement vector. So we have to follow these steps. So first, then you have to know what is r vector. If I know r vector, I'll find from here dr over dt. I'll differentiate that equation. Again, I'll differentiate this equation d by dt of dr over dt. That will give me acceleration. So from here to here, I'm getting v velocity vector. Here, I'm getting acceleration vector. So one differentiation will give me this. And again, one differentiation here will give me this. This is the process that we're going to adopt. Now, the first important thing is to find the expression, this expression, or write the radius vector at any instant, because this gives me instantaneous acceleration. And this one is the instantaneous velocity. So these are all instantaneous. So at any instant of time, the radius vector I have to find. So when it is at B, this is the, at that instant, radius vector is R. Now this from this B position to any other position, you have to move. Then during that time, at this point to any other point, say here, very nearby point, then suppose from here to here also, if I consider is moving from here to here, then this was its initial radius vector, and now this is the displacement. This is the displacement vector, say ds vector, and this is supposed to be r1 vector. Suppose this is r2 vector, because these are the initial and final positions for under our consideration. So a and b are treated as initial and final conditions. This is r1, this is r2, and this one is dr. We know that this plus this vector is this vector. So this is a change in the radius vector, the change in the position vector, the change in the position vector with respect to time is nothing but the velocity vector. So the velocity vector is obtained by this one. So if at any instant of time I know to find the expression for r, because the r expression can I be written at any instant, because I can consider from here to here, or I can consider from here to here. So in that small span of time, the change in this delta r gives me the velocity. So this change in here correspondingly corresponds to nearly the same point B, is because that point is very close to B. I can think of that point as B point. So I will have to draw the diagram like this and proceed. I'll draw the diagram. This is a circle. This is my x-axis. This is my y-axis. This is the I cap. And this is the j cap over here. This is the point, any points at P here. I consider that as B there. And corresponding to this point, this is the position vector, suppose r vector. How fast or slow this r vector is changing, that is the velocity. So the this point is suppose O. I will draw a perpendicular from here. And I want to write this r in terms of this I cap and j cap. If this angle is theta, corresponding to this position P, this theta is the angular position. If this is r, this is theta, then this vector from here to here, suppose this point is m, dropping a perpendicular from this point to the x-axis. This is PM, this is OM, and in this triangle, we know that if this is R, this is theta, this is your R cos theta. So this OM is nothing but R cos theta in terms of magnitude, and this one is R sine theta in terms of magnitude. So this is R cos theta, and this is R sine theta, and we can write this vector as in terms of its components, that is OM vector plus MP vector. This R vector and OM vector is nothing but this R cos theta vector, or I'll write R cos theta, and in terms of vector I'll multiply this I cap. Similarly, this will be r sine theta, and this is in this direction, which is in y direction, this j cap. So this is my r vector. Once you get the r vector, you have to proceed in the following manners. First derivative, then second derivative. You have to differentiate this equation two times, one after another, and we get the answer. So r I write here and keep on differentiating two times. The r vector is r cos theta I cap plus r sine theta j cap. Differentiating this equation with respect to time, I will have dr over dt because I want velocity, then I want acceleration. This is differentiation, this equation with respect to time. I will differentiate that d by dt of the whole thing. That means I will have to differentiate these two terms separately. This is r is a constant, comes out. So r comes out. I have to actually differentiate cos theta, which is minus sine theta. So minus of sine theta and d theta over dt because I had to differentiate with respect to t. So it is d theta over dt. This is an I cap is there. So, and differentiating this one, so plus differentiating this one, this r is there. Sine theta is cos theta. Differentiation theta is there, so it is d theta over dt, and j cap is there only for direction. Now from here I write, this is minus r, this d theta over dt is omega sine theta I cap plus r omega cos theta j cap. Okay, now this is my v, velocity vector. Now this velocity vector is differentiated again with respect to time to get acceleration. So instantaneous acceleration can be obtained by differentiation of this equation, that is dv over dt. If I differentiate this equation, what I will get? So I'll get d by dt of the whole expression, I'll write again here, this one is the derivative, minus r omega sine theta I cap plus r omega cos theta j cap. Now this acceleration a, instantaneous acceleration, is a differentiation of these two terms. This one will be constant, remain there. So minus r omega will remain there. Differentiation of this term is cos theta. Again, it is d theta by dt will be there. And I cap. Differentiation of this term, the cos is there. So it will become minus r omega is earlier there. Cos theta is minus of sine theta. And theta is d theta over dt. And j cap is there. This one can be written as omega here and omega there. So it is r omega square. So minus, I'll just rewrite that for you, minus r omega into omega cos theta I cap. This one, r omega omega cos theta I cap. Similarly, minus r omega omega sine theta j cap. So what was that? Minus r omega omega sine theta j cap. This is what we have derived so far. Now from here, this is in vector form obviously, and because we are using vector here, this is minus r omega square cos theta I cap minus r omega square sine theta j cap. So you can see that this minus omega square r is common from both sides. So then I write that this is minus omega square, I will take common. Inside the bracket, I will have r cos theta I cap plus r sine theta j cap. What I've done is that I took omega square out of the common from these two terms. So it is left with this. So I don't want this r outside, I want this r inside, because I want this to be represented or presented in terms of r vector. Earlier in the first equation itself, if I consider, say, I say, suppose this is equation 1, if look at this equation 1 is r vector which is r cos theta I cap plus r sin theta j cap. So in the whole of this I write r vector. So this r cos theta I cap, r sin theta j cap, this is also equation 1 and this is r vector. So I'll write this is minus omega square r vector. So this a vector comes out to be this. So if it is so, the magnitude part of this acceleration is omega square r magnitude. This is exactly what we got last time, that last time we got acceleration as v square by r in geometrical method. And if I put v equals to omega r, then what I'm getting? Omega square r. So this is the same expression I'm getting here, but in terms of vector, so that the direction will be more profound or clearly seen here. What is the direction that we'll discuss here? A expression comes out to be minus of omega square r vector. So when there are two vectors and minus is there, this means that the direction of this vector and the direction of this vector are opposite. So in a circular motion, if a particle is moving in this sense, suppose from here to here to here, the r vector at any position, suppose this is a position, r vector is this way, this is the direction of r vector, and at that point the acceleration, if I want to find, then it is opposite to this vector, that is this direction, therefore they are negative here. So this is radially inward. And r vector direction is radially outward. Its direction is radially outward, its direction is radially inward. So therefore this minus sign. So at this position, if I want to say this radius vector centripetal acceleration will be radially inward. At this position also radially inward. And acceleration vector is radially outward. So there is r vector is radially outward, r vector, and centripetal acceleration radially inward. So at any position, suppose here this is the direction of r vector, and obviously in the opposite direction we have got centripetal acceleration. So in general, if I want to make the picture clear, I can have this situation that if I have a circular motion, only if I want to draw the centripetal acceleration, then at this point it is toward the center. At this point, suppose it is toward the center, so centripetal acceleration is always directed toward the center. This is centripetal acceleration, always toward the center. And the formula that we have derived is v square by r, omega square r, or v omega, that is the derivations. Okay, thank you very much.